I'm Jenny Reese, and I was born in 1927, September 10th, a little town in Winona, Missouri, 350 people, from a family of six, and then I had some half-brothers and sisters, too. My father died when I was 14, and my mother and my sister moved to Oregon. And it didn't work out for my mom. She wanted to go back to Missouri, so she and I went back. And we moved to St. Louis, and I went to high school in St. Louis. And after I graduated from high school, my sister, who was already here in Seattle, she wanted us to come out here and live. So we moved out here. And I met my husband here, and we were married for almost 60 years, and he passed away, and we had five children, and that's it. We lived in Seattle until we got married, and well, we moved to Mercer Island in 1951, so we've been there a long time. Well, I can't remember too much, having five kids, but I think I always was drawing something or doing something. And I sold my first painting at a church art show that we had, and that sort of made me come alive. So, but I think it's always been with me to do it. I've always been interested in painting and drawing. I started doing some oil, and then I quit that and started doing watercolor. I took a weekend workshop on Mercer Island with Jerry Becker, and I just loved it. We did little paintings, and then I started taking classes at the community center on Mercer Island and at Bellevue Community College, and doing workshops and going to art groups. And I just loved watercolor. Probably about in 1983 or 4, something like that. But I started the classes, and I joined different groups. I joined MIVO, and I joined MIVO in 1982, and that was a big group on Mercer Island. We had a big art show every year. I think it was one of the biggest ones in the area. And I joined that, and then I became a signature member in 1985 of Northwest Watercolor. And then I joined EFA, which is East Side Association of Fine Arts. And in 1993, I was voted into Women Painters of Washington. And I was president of MIVO and president of Women Painters of Washington at different times. So, Mercer Island Visual Arts League, and I was president in 1995. And I was president of Women Painters of Washington in 1993. And that's been very helpful, because you're on boards and you know how the organizations work. And it just gives you an insight to the group and what's going on. Yeah. I would recommend that to anybody. Well, my husband was a watchmaker besides being a Boeing engineer. And her daughter lived in Alaska, and she wanted her watch fixed. She had a nursing watch or something, I think it was. And so my husband fixed the watch for her, and Nancy brought it up to the house, and she gave him a pair of mukluks that she made. Her daughter made mukluks. And she gave him a pair of mukluks for doing her watch. And that's how I met Nancy.
I didn't know that was the first time.
Yeah, that was
was the first time. I think I'd seen you, but I hadn't.
Yeah, formally. Talked much. I knew who she was and everything.
I think that was the early 80s.
Yeah, it was early 80s.
Yeah. It's going to make me
cheer up.
We've been friends for so long. It's meant a lot because we did so many things together and supported each other in our art. And we belong to the same organizations, the Mercer Island Visual Arts League, Women Painters of Washington, and Northwest Watercolor Society. So we were active on the boards of those. And Jenny was president of two of them, and I was president of the Watercolor Society. So we were kind of
in this
together.
Just
we've
friends.
Been friends and enjoyed the same thing.
We could talk about the things, same thing. She knew what I was doing and I knew what she was doing, and we talk about different art things.
And we took a lot of workshops together,
yeah.
So that
workshops.
Was where we really enjoyed watching each other paint too. Painting is a solitary thing, so it's always good to have somebody to talk with about things. And
yeah.
We've done a lot of that.
Yeah, we have. Well, I have a cousin. I had a cousin, Charles Wesley Copeland. He was an illustrator of paperbacks books in New York. And we grew up together in a little town in Missouri, and I always admired what he did. He could draw anything. And I always admired him. And I think I had him in the back of my mind all these years. And then when I started taking classes at the community center on Mercer Island, I had a teacher, Margette Shelley, and she was really good. And I think she influenced me a lot. And then I took classes from Jess Cawthorn, and he was a good teacher. And then Ann Brecken, who's teaches around Seattle. She sort of influenced me too. So those are three of my main people. Having a family and five kids. Well, one of the challenges was trying to find time to paint, you know, and work on my art. And that's been a big challenge. And then painting for art shows, and you feel vulnerable, put your work out and let other people see it and critique it. That's been a challenge. I've kind of gotten over that, but now I just let it go. I just put it out, and whatever happens, happens. Sometimes you get in, sometimes you don't. So you just do what you have to do.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm happy about it. And I'm happy because people appreciate my work. And I think I've helped people along the way because they like it so much. And I just had a letter, one lady had written to me. She was dying. She had cancer and was dying, and I gave her a small painting, and the last thing she did was write a letter, and her husband sent it to me, how much she appreciated it. And that really made me feel good. And meeting other artists has been great, because I don't think there's any artist that I've met that I don't like. You know, they're all great. They're all friends, and you just feel like you know them all your life. And my knowledge of art and the thought process that goes with it, it's all been really good.
That's great.
Yeah. Oh, it's beautiful. Just being able to have a piece of white paper and put down the colors, it's just great. And so when I paint my florals, they just come to life, and I love all of them. Because I draw first, And that takes a while to get all the drawing down. I'm very detailed. And I draw it all out first. And then my mind sort of tells me where I'm going. And I can get it done. Sometimes I have to rework it. A lot of times. I do paint from photographs. But sometimes I use two or three photographs and mix them. If I need a bud here, I'll take that and put it in the painting. Yeah. So, but it's just a joy to do it.
Yeah.
I'm not happy if I'm not painting or in the process of painting. I don't know. I suppose there was a time when I thought, well, I never think I'm good enough. I'm always doing it and trying to do it better. And I guess maybe I'm good, I don't know. It's just something that you do, and if it turns out good, that's good. I think to learn everything you can and to read books. I have lots of books and I've learned a lot from my books. I don't take as many workshops as some people do, but I get a lot of information out of my books. And if I have a problem, I can always go to somebody, and one of my books can answer it for me. And I would just urge them to paint every day if they can. I try to paint every day. And just enjoy it and just do it. I haven't thought too much about it, but I'm sure my kids have thought about it. And I have lots of paintings that they're going to have to get rid of when I do go. But,
Well, I think the beauty of being painting partners, being friends, and being in the same organization, we could support each other in many things. And I feel that Jenny's work, I've just watched her get better and better through the years and winning all kinds of awards, and rightfully so, selling her work. And it's just been a joy to watch that. And we always have supported each other, and I think that's what's been important.